Welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to introduce rules for differentiation of a function of a single variable, x. So, rules of differentiation. One, so the basic one is what you call the constant. Rule. Number two is what we call the power rule. Number three is what we call constant multiple rule. Number four is what we call the sum and difference rule. Number five is what we call the product rule. Number six is what we call the quotient rule. Number seven is what we call the chain rule. Now, these others may not be called rules, but then it's also other way of differentiation. So there's what we call logarithmic. Differentiation. There's what you call implicit differentiation. So now, before we start discussing each of these rules, let us discuss about derivatives of some special functions. So derivative of trigonometric functions. So in form of a question, given that y equals to sine x, what is dy dx? So that's the question, that if you have a sine function, what is its derivative? Let's give a solution. Solution. Y equals to sine x, the same language as same. The function we are dealing with is sine x. Then say, by definition, f prime of x is limit as h approaches 0, f of x plus h minus f of x over h. So this is how we define derivative of a function. And remember, the f prime is the same as dy dx. There's two mean the same. If the limit exists. Now, we have f of x is given by sine x. So this is what we have in the equation. This implies f of x plus h will be given by sine of x plus h. And since sine a plus b is given by sine a plus b plus cos a sine b, then we write this one, sine of x plus h, as sine x cos h plus cos x sine h. So making use of this identity. So this means that dy dx, which is f prime of x, will be limit as h approaches zero of sine of x cosine of h plus cosine of x sine of h minus f of x is sine x, then we divide everything by h. Now you see the numerator has three terms. So this is the first term, second term, third term. So what I do, I bring this third term closer to the second to the first term, because these two terms have sine x. So I say dy dx will be limit as h approaches zero, and then sine x cosine of h minus sine x, and then plus cosine of x sine h, and then everything divided by h. Now, considering this rearrangement, these two terms here, sine x is common. So I say dy dx or f prime of x is given by limit as h approaches zero. Now this one, I write it as sine x into cos h minus one divided by h, and then plus cos of x sine h divided by h, and then I put in this square bracket. Remember, when if you have two terms, a plus b over c, the same as a over c plus b over c. So I've taken this one to be one. So I divide by h, then this other one I also divide by h. And this will have limit as h approaches zero of sine of x cosine of h minus one over h plus, now I supply limit on all the terms, limit as h approaches zero of cos of x sine h divided by h. Now, since this limit is affecting only h, sine x is a constant, so I can write this one as sine x, and then limit times limit h approaching zero of cos h minus one over h plus limit, this one I factor out cosine. So plus cosine x times limit as h approaches zero sine h over h. But remember that limit as h approaches zero of cosine of h minus one over h is 0, and limit as h approaches 0 of sine of h over h is 1. These two identities were proved when you are studying limits. So which means that, so this was dy dx. So dy dx, that dy dx will be equals to sine x. This limit is 0 plus cosine of x. This limit is 1. So which tells us that dy dx is cosine of x. So this is the solution. Then part B, question 2, given y equals to cosine of x, dy dx is equals, so same argument, dy dx, which is the same as f prime of x, is limit as h approaches 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h, provided the limit exists. This by definition. So from definition, which tells us that we'll have dy dx is limit as h approaches 0 of cosine of x plus h minus cos of x divided by h. Now we know that cosine of a plus b is given by cosine of a, cosine of b, minus sine of a, sine of b. So with this identity, we write this part as dy dx equals to limit as h approaches 0 of now cos x cos h minus sine x sine h minus cos x divided by h. So this implies that dy dx will be, now bring this term closer to this, limit as h approaches 0, cosine of x, cosine of h, minus cosine of x, minus sine x, sine h, divided by h. Now, this can be written as dy dx is equals to limit as h approaches 0 of cos x into cos h minus 1 over h minus sine x sine h divided by h. So this, from here we come to this. Now, laws of limits, we can distribute limits to each of these two terms. So dy dx is limit as h approaches 0, cosine of x into cos h minus 1 over h minus limit h approaches 0, sine of x, sine of h over h. Since this limit is with respect to h, then we can factor out these terms with x. So dy dx is equals to cosine of x times limit h approaching 0, cos of h minus 1 over h, minus sine of x limit as h approaches 0 of sine h over h. And with the same argument from the previous problem, this limit is 0 and this limit is 1. So this means dy dx or f prime is cosine of x times 0 minus sine of x times 1. So this implies that dy dx is minus sine x. So that's what we have. And lastly, third problem, if y is e raised to power x, dy dx is equals to, so solution from definition, dy dx is the same as f prime of x, which is limit as h approaches 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h, provided the limit exists. Now we'll have dy dx will be given by limit as h approaches 0, e raised to h, x plus h, minus e raised to x over h. So the power is x plus h. Now, this is the same as limit h approaches 0. This can be written as e raised to power x, e raised to power h, minus e raised to power x over h. This is just loss of indices. Now, numerator has, those two terms of the numerator have common term e raised to power x, so dy dx will be limit as h approaches 0, e raised to power x into e raised to power h, minus 1 over h. And then from the study of limits, note that limit as theta approaches 0 of e raised to power theta minus 1 over theta is 1. It's a property of limits. So that implies that dy dx, now since the limit is with respect to h, then we can factor out e power x and then times limit e raised power h minus 1 divided by h, h approaches 0. And then from this property of limits, this property, this part is 1. So this implies dy dx is e raised power x. So that's how we work out the derivatives of those two functions, cos x sine x, and then this exponential function e raised power x. Now the other trigonometric derivatives can always be obtained from the derivative of cosine and sine. Thank you.